You know what's worse? If it's flaming, the what if the guy never turned took out the key?
I know.
Look, it's still catching on fire.
Oh my God! Do you guys see it? Hi, do you want to explain the story?
I don't know. A bunch of stupid idiots tried to pull out their car and it wouldn't budge. So they keep on putting it in drive and then reverse, trying to budge it out, and then it starts smoking.
Was it from the tires or?
At first I thought it was from the tires, but since it's actually on fire, I think it's the engine.
You think they just put too much stress on the engine?
Yeah,
and especially
you're not supposed to,
the way it contracts with the cold and heat, right now.
Well, no, you're not supposed to make car
more
engine move without the wheels actually turning.
Do you think there's no more fire, or do you still see it? Some
don't know. They're still checking, I think, the firefighters.
They're probably also determining how the fuck it got on fire. Excuse my language.
Oh, hey, look.
Hey, look, you can see the little GPS in there. They have like a little LCD screen. It's cute. That's pretty much it. There's more firefighters.
Imagine the fire engines got stuck.
That'd be bad. Where did Kira go?
Here.
And here's my little kitty. I think he smelled something too. So here's Kira looking at me. And Howard says I should try to record more of this. I don't know why. They
That's
brought
crazy,
a big bulldozer.
Because there's a bulldozer just tacked as a snowplow. The firefighter's digging out the hydrant.
There's people looking out the window. I don't know if you can see, but that person's looking. Not only us. And thankfully, Howard's younger brother called.
He was calling, but I think someone else called.
Hopefully someone else also called, because that would have been dangerous to have, like, the retarded people who had that car and imagine if they didn't call and they left a flaming car here. So, something bad would have been happening.